In our last video, we covered how to populate your parameters collection with your parameters. In this video, we'll cover how to add labels to your parameters and how to find the parameter you're looking for. Labels are metadata that you can attach to your parameters. As we covered from the last video, we automatically generate labels in a few instances. We create a label with the name of any uploaded shared parameters file and that file's groups. We add the new from Revit label to any parameter uploaded from a Revit file. Beyond these, the rest is completely up to you. Labels are completely flexible. They can be used to help you define the parameter however you want. To add a label, log into the service as an admin either through ACC or via the Manage tool from the Revit ribbon. Then select Labeling View. If you select Add Labels, you'll see you get a message that there's no parameter selected. To have a label, it needs to be attached to at least one parameter. Once you select a parameter, you'll see there's a list of all the existing labels. These are all the labels from our shared parameter file upload. Simply check any labels that you want to add to the selected parameter. To add a new label, type in the name of the label that you want to add. The list will filter to ensure you're not creating a duplicate label, and you will see New Label in parentheses. If you click the checkbox next to this one, it will create the new label and apply it to the parameter. You can select multiple parameters with Shift and click, selecting their checkboxes to apply labels in bulk. To remove a label, simply select the parameter or parameters and uncheck that label to remove it. The power of labels is that you can easily filter down to similar parameters or parameters for a given use. For example, if you're working on a certain type of family, you may have a label to help further specify what you need. To explore this more, let's look at the search and filtering capabilities of the parameters service. First, you can search. Just type in your search term and hit enter. In this instance, I'm interested in window parameters, so I've typed in win and hit enter. Now, I see all parameters with win in the name, and this collection has an existing naming convention with win as a prefix for window parameters. But we're unsure if there's a parameter in the collection that isn't matching that naming convention. Here, I can open the Filters tab. I can immediately see what labels apply to the current search or filter. Selecting a label will narrow my search further, but in this instance, I'll clear this search, then select to filter by a label. Here, I see more granularity, such as window trim and window frames, so there's some more specificity here. However, there's a lot of options for making sure our data is correct. Let's clear the filter again. This time I'll select by category. Note you will only see the categories applied to parameters in your collection when filtering. I can now see there are several more parameters that were missing from the other label filters. I can now label my parameters correctly, ensuring I have a complete set of data when filtering by those labels. Let's explore all the options in the filter panel. We've already touched on labels. We can filter by the property palette group. This may be helpful to find parameters of a specific use or to help clean up data by looking at the other property palette group. Discipline can help you find parameters pertaining to certain uses. Data type allows you to find parameters by the data they represent. If you're wondering if you already have a parameter that represents, say, an area, you can quickly find all of your area parameters with a simple filter. We've covered categories. Below categories are a bunch of switches to filter by the flags applied to parameters. You can filter by those that are type or instance parameters, whether they're hidden or whether they are read-only. When launching from Revit, you also get an option to hide any parameters that are already in the active model. Remember, the filter panel updates dynamically with your existing selections, so you will only see options available for what's already in your results. One additional ability we give you is to create saved filters. Once you have a specific set of parameters that you want to use often, whether through search, filters, or a combination thereof, you can save that search. Once you have your list on screen, select Save This Search and give it a unique name. Now everyone in your account can use this filter to quickly find a specific use. Let's walk through a simple example workflow. As a BIM manager, I want my users who are modeling content to always be using a defined set of parameters. I want every kitchen or casework family to require a preset list of parameters to be included. I can use a saved search called Kitchens Content to quickly and consistently return the right list of parameters and add them to the family. Every user across my company can be using and loading the same set in line with our company's standards and best practices. Alternatively, to use a different example, furniture or mechanical equipment categories may be too generic. With labels, I can quickly find the parameters relating to specific types of equipment or furniture. I can even add an accessible label so we can filter to doors, cabinets, and other components that have specific handicapped accessible parameters. We hope this will give you another tool for managing your parametric data and allow you to quickly get to what you need so you can add these parameters to your Revit projects and families with as few steps as possible. In our next video, we'll explore how to edit your parameters in bulk.